So you're building a PC for the first time. Now you might be tempted to jump right in and get to the motherboard, graphics card, or CPU, but there's one important thing that often gets overlooked, and that is memory. Hey guys, I'm Luna and you are watching QuikTIPS, a brand new video series where we answer all of your tech questions. Today we are talking about SSDs. Let's get started! Now before we go any further, first, what is an SSD? So SSD stands for solid state drive, which is a storage device that functions similarly to a hard drive, except that unlike hard drives, which use a platter or disk mechanism, SSDs use something called flash memory to store data. So why should you buy an SSD? Chances are, you probably already have some kind of hard drive. So you may be thinking, is it even necessary to have an SSD? Here's the thing. They're way faster and smaller. This means that you'll be able to store and access your data much faster than with traditional hard drives. So whatever programs or files you want to open, like video games, music, or photos, or other software, you're going to notice a significant boost in performance across the board. So now that we know what an SSD is, let's talk about the different types that are available. So the most common types of connection interfaces out there are SATA, PCIe, and M.2. In storage capacity, they range anywhere from typically 256 gigabytes all the way up to 1 terabyte. SATA, or serial ATA, is the most common type of connection interface, and usually comes in a 2.5 inch form factor. They have better hardware compatibility, which means that whether you have a desktop or a laptop, they're pretty much guaranteed to work with your system. PCIe, or Peripheral Component Interconnect Express, uses a direct data connection to your motherboard. This allows for faster communication between your SSD and the motherboard. In fact, PCIe SSDs can have transfer speeds of up to 3 times faster than SATA SSDs. Lastly, we have M.2, which offers the best of both worlds. The great thing about M.2 is that they're super versatile because they can be compatible with both SATA and PCIe devices. Something to keep in mind with M.2 SSDs is that, depending on your motherboard, you might need an enclosure, which basically acts as an adapter for your SSD. In terms of price, SATA is definitely the most budget-friendly option. For the faster speeds that PCIe offers, you'll definitely pay more, while M.2 is the most expensive option. To figure out which interface is best for your system, you'll first have to find out which connector types are compatible with your motherboard. Now it's time for the key question. What type of SSD should you buy? So this really depends on what you're using it for. So for example, if you're a gamer, an SSD is a must-have in order to speed up loading times and help the games run faster and smoother. If you're just doing some casual gaming and playing lower spec games, you could definitely get by with a 480 gigabyte SATA SSD. But you also might want to consider getting something with a bit more storage capacity, like a 960 gigabyte. Now, if you're a more hardcore gamer playing high spec games, you'll probably want to consider getting something more powerful, like a 1 terabyte PCIe SSD. Or maybe you're a designer. In that case, if you're doing some graphic design on, for example, Photoshop, then for sure, a 512 gigabyte SATA SSD would be more than enough. But for more resource-intensive tasks, like 3D design or video editing, then something like a 1 terabyte M.2 or a PCIe SSD will definitely make your life a lot easier, especially for rendering and exporting large files. This goes for programmers and developers as well. Having an SSD will do wonders for accelerating your PC's performance. Faster boot times, file transfers, downloads, you name it. Perhaps none of these apply to you, and you just need something for your work computer to store your documents on. For this, a 480 gigabyte SATA SSD would be perfect for the job. One last thing that you might want to consider before pulling the trigger on your first SSD is the warranty period. Typically, most SSDs come with a 3-year warranty period, but sometimes higher-end drives have a 5-year warranty. So there you have it, SSDs in a nutshell. Hopefully you now have a better idea of what SSDs are, the different kinds, and most importantly, which one is right for you. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and if you have any tech questions, you can let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.